Hello, Chiefs Kingdom, and welcome once again to the practice field here in St. Joe. Mitch Holtis with you, voice of the Chiefs, along with Chiefs reporter Matt McMullen. Our report's brought to you by the incredible people at Mosaic. A reminder, they're having a vaccination event on campus here. It's coming up the 12th of August at the Looney Complex. That's where the Griffins and Lady Griffins play basketball and volleyball. It'll be set up for you and a great chance for folks here in the region to get vaccinated. All right, welcome to the dog days. Bow, wow, bark, bark. This day felt like our first dog day of camp.
Yeah, no kidding. I mean, we talk about the dog days. This is definitely it. It's hot, and we're just in t-shirts and shorts. We came down here after being in our tent for, we're down here, what, half an hour? And we're sweating. I can't imagine practicing in this. Just talked to Creed Humphrey a bit ago, and he was squishing in his shoes. He was so sweaty. But these guys are getting work in. That's the important thing. Pushing through this time, because the adrenaline of the initial first week of camp is over. For these young guys now, it's about powering through that, getting through that, and getting better. And these are the days that make you better.
You always look at individuals who can push that and do the very thing you're talking about. And to me, a couple guys come to mind. It's the second-year defenders for me. Looking at Tershawn Wharton today, or a guy like Mike Dana. Mike Dana brought it today, whether it was in one-on-ones or in the teamwork.
We've been hitting this point over and over again, but these guys didn't have in-person OTAs and minicamp last year. They finally had all of that this year, in addition to a rookie season, and now they can come into this camp with more than just their athleticism. They can come into everything with a plan, and they can approach one-on-ones or team drills or whatever they may be doing with a plan defensively, and that's huge. We're going to see huge growth from these players. Even Bo Pete Keys, saw him with an interception today as well.
And L'Jarius Sneed. Last year, we quoted a lot of his stats, but the fact that this guy only played 9 regular season games and had 41 tackles and 3 picks and 7 passes defensed, we saw a little bit of that today. His vertical, his ability to cover downfield showed up today, even on a day where he had to grind through the heat.
What's so impressive about him is he's playing two positions. He's playing slot corner in nickel and outside corner in base, and that is not easy to do. It's not as simple as, well, you're a corner, you can play wherever. No, those are two totally different positions, and he's bringing the athleticism and the speed we knew he had last year and the ball-hawking skills to both positions, looking very good so far in camp.
That's a great point. It's like he has to learn Spanish and French and be bilingual here. On the offensive side, one thing that was apparent, there was some situational work again, but we know about Patrick Mahomes, the play after the play, the play call and then whatever happens when Patrick makes something happen. But we also saw today, it was interesting, that permeated through the second and third team offense.
Well, we saw Anthony Gordon rolling with the pressure after him, fires a dart across the middle and finds Maurice French in the back of the end zone. These are the kind of things that show what the culture is like here in Kansas City. You don't stop running. If the play is dead, it's never dead. Keep going. And it's not just Patrick Mahomes. We're seeing that permeate throughout the rest of the quarterback room.
Yeah, if those guys get a tattoo on their ankle, it's keep playing and keep running. How many times you hear Patrick go keep running? Okay, we'll get you up to speed even tomorrow. We're going to have a live stream for you, so make sure you follow us that about 9:15, and then we'll give you an update as well as we keep you updated on your favorite team. Yes, that first preseason game just a few shopping days away as the Chiefs go to the 49ers.